We have, and we went through all of our different partner Charleston basic things that you can lead, like different steps. We started with leading descriptive steps.
So first we established the baseline, right, so that we can meet differences. We have the triple steps. We can put it on the tail line. Triple steps. And we're talking about slides next. What we're going to do. We bring it towards us, so we slide out, and this is one of those moves that we can take. So we can keep it in the feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or you can make it as long as you want. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You can keep going until 1.
Yeah.
So as long as you can move, you can keep it going.
One of the things also that we mentioned is that whenever you're leading this kind of thing, you want to figure out, because it's not intuitive sometimes, you have to kind of figure out, well, how do I do this? You want to think about the different elements of the movement. So movement has different shapes, takes on different shapes. It might take on different framing or tone in your body. It might take on different amounts of momentum or energy across the floor. So really think about those different elements. So the triple steps have a little bit of a different shape as we and energy than like the slide. The shape is a little, for the pre-lead, is a little bit similar, but the triple steps got more energy behind it, more push through. Then we talked about the Johnny Straw. We showed you guys all how to
One more thing about the slide, though. Sorry.
Oh,
so
the
we talked scary. About instead of bringing it straight across, you can add that incline, sort of like going up a roller coaster at the beginning before it drops. Right? So we have that slide, bring the energy up, and drop it. You also can release that energy at the same time.
Yes.
And then the Johnny Straw, that's what we're talking about, where you make space
drop
between
step.
Us.
Okay.
And you lunge through by moving your body through and your arms at the same time.
Now, for that though, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, hold 8, and drop 7. But what we worked on in class is so can actually keep going into that crossover. So you need to do crossover. Drop, step, kick, drop, kick, drop. And he's actually pulling me in and pushing me out with his pulling up also.
And do it with a Johnny's drop or with a slide on the other side?
Yeah, here's the slide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the last thing we talked about was moving her in and out of like a 20 Charleston position, where he's just taking his hand on my back here and moving me on. He pushes on 2, and he catches on 5,
4 and 6, and go back. And that way you can enter and exit right away. 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, or would you keep her that way? Touch, step, touch. Step, catch, pull, and bring it back.
Now we talked to the ladies about really going with the momentum of where he sent you. So he sends me that way, even though he turned me, I've got this momentum going that way. And I'm going to keep going that way until I hit the wall there.
She keeps
now
going,
going that way.
Until she reaches the wall here.
Boom. So he's sending me.
The walls in a shorter amount of time.
And that's hard to see when we're teaching it, because it's invisible stuff that's kind of happening with the pressing in of our body, so it's invisible sometimes. That's everything that we did today, you guys. Thank you guys.